Let's get to something a little bit different, but businessy. Good news for consumers in a case of credit card competition. A tribunal has tossed out a complaint by retailers over fees charged by credit card companies. Our next guest was going to break down this decision for us and what it means to Canadian shoppers. Joining me is Ashley Patterson. She is the senior finance editor at Yahoo Canada. Ashley, thank you for being here once again.
Thanks for having me.
So let me ask you, these credit card changes were, so the retailers now will not have to pay a premium? Is that what it is? Or that premium won't be tossed over to the shoppers, to consumers?
Exactly. So the tribunal dismissed the case, which was brought about by the Competition Bureau on behalf of merchants, saying that we would like to impose a surcharge on consumers because we're already paying between 1.5% and 3% in fees, which are imposed by the credit card company. And this not only reduces competition in the market, but it's essentially doing a disservice to consumers. And the tribunal tossed the case out, saying actually it's going to remain status quo. So what this means is that when you're paying with a premium credit card, you're not going to see a surcharge on that credit card. But whether or not this is actually good news for consumers, it's kind of in the gray area right now. The big banks have definitely won out, and credit card companies have won out in this decision.
Why is it great for us?
Well, it's great because you're not going to see that surcharge on your bill. So, you know, if you're buying a $1,000 couch and you're getting a 3% surcharge, that's $30 just to pay with a credit card as opposed to paying with cash. But if retailers are rolling in that surcharge into their prices already, then if you're a cash-carrying consumer, you're already getting dinged as it is. So that's really where the discrepancy lies. Now, if the decision was reversed and if we actually see an appeal process go through and that surcharge is placed upon consumers, retailers would have to disclose that. But as a consumer who's paying for a premium card, if you already have an annual fee of $100 on your card, you're paying interest on that purchase, and then you're going to be slapped potentially with a surcharge for that purchase. Are you going to pay with cash or are you going to pay with your credit card? You're most likely going to be paying with cash if you have it on hand, because it's just going to be that much more expensive to pay with plastic.
And you're saying already if the retailers start rolling in this fee, I mean, that goes even to people that pay cash.
Absolutely.
It's going to cost everybody.
Absolutely. So consumers are kind of damned if you do, damned if you don't. It's a double-edged sword right now.
This is something that's actually not that odd in the rest of the world. I mean, if you go to Hong Kong, you will see that surcharge added to the amount that whatever you pay. So let's say you go to, you go to Louis Vuitton in Hong Kong, and right, you're going to see that there's a surcharge for you using a premium card.
Right. So it really depends on where you're spending around the globe. So last year in the U.S., we saw that there was a $7.25 billion antitrust settlement reached between Visa and MasterCard and merchants. And basically, it was over the same surcharge. They were saying that, you know, we want to have the right to pass this charge on to consumers. So now, not only are Visa and MasterCard going to be lowering the fees that they charge merchants, but also if you purchase anything on plastic in the States, the merchant will have the right to pass that on to you, but they do have to disclose it at checkout. So those rules are going to be coming into effect later this year. In Europe, actually, a story just broke yesterday that the European Commission has put forward a draft law which will say not only do Visa and MasterCard have to reduce these interchange fees, but that they can't be passed on to consumers. So really, depending on where you're shopping around the world and what kind of credit card you're using, I mean, it depends on, it's going to leave a lasting mark on your bill, you know, depending on how much you're spending.
The funny thing is, and I was just talking to David Menzies a little earlier about this, the fact is, in this day and age, you need to have a credit card. You can't rent a car without a credit card. You can't get a hotel room without a credit card. Back in the day, you know, here's my license and some cash and everything's fine. It's just one of those things that you can't live without, and it seems that you get dinged. You're just damned if you do, damned if you don't, really, with it.
Absolutely.
But there is some good news for consumers, too, and that's that there's a little bit of competition between credit cards.
Right, so competition is definitely going to be heating up in the Canadian space. We see that new account growth is actually diminishing, so people aren't signing up for more cards as we go along as Canadian consumers. So that means that the card companies that are currently in this country are going to be offering, you know, better rebates, lower interest rates, zero balance transfers, all of these kind of perks, you know, double rewards if you sign up, to get more people to sign up for cards. Now, that's a good news story if you actually have a handle on your debt and if you actually know how to use credit effectively. If you don't, and because banks and credit card companies need to be recouping profit, obviously, they need to be recouping more revenue, if you don't have a handle on your credit, then that means that you may see higher penalty fees. You may see higher interest rates if you have, you know, a low credit score. So really, it could mean good news if you actually are really a good credit consumer, but if you have a problem with your credit card debt, then you might actually be getting dinged more.
Okay, so tell me very quickly, for those people that have a problem with their credit card debt, because I mean, it's so easy to rack those things up. What do they need to do to get out of that situation?
First and foremost, you need to figure out which credit card has the highest interest rate and which one you're paying the most on per month. So depending on what your balance is and what the interest rate is, you need to attack that debt. You need to rebalance your budget to find that kind of wiggle room so that you can start not only paying, you have to pay more than the minimum, and you have to really start attacking that principal. So look at your budget, look at what you're paying the most on, and really start with that one first.
All right, perfect. Thank you, Ashley.
You're welcome.
And that was Ashley Patterson, Senior Finance Editor at Yahoo Canada.